Hey Romano,
Hey, Paddy, what's going on?
I have a problem actually.
Okay, what's the sorrow?
Well, it happened again. I had to do a security review for an application.
Okay.
And well, as always, I did find some issues in there.
Yeah, at least you found it before they went live.
Yeah, but now they blame me because they can't go live with their issues.
Okay, but why didn't they have checked the security earlier in the whole process?
That's a good question. I think they have no idea how.
Okay, but as always, you can shift left this whole security testing in the process so that you can earlier find security bugs. And there are great tools out there which can provide you with an automation for that.
Oh, that sounds cool. I want to learn about that. Can you help me?
Yeah, sure. Let's have a look. Hi, and welcome to our new video about what is GitLab. My name is Romano Roth, and I'm the Chief of DevOps. And today is with me, Paddy Stegel.
Thanks for the introduction, Romano. I'm Paddy, and I'm a principal consultant for security.
So, Paddy, first of all, we need to identify what do we really want. And for that, we need to recognize that we are building products here. And a product is something that is continuously evolving, which means we need to continuously create new features in this product. And for that, we have this infinity symbol, which you can see here, which is the DevOps infinity symbol. And as said before, we need to shift left the whole security. We cannot do security testing at the end before we are releasing our product to the customer. We need to do that earlier in the process, and we need to automate that. And to do that, we need to build up a CI/CD pipeline.
That sounds interesting. Can you elaborate on that, please?
Yeah, sure. So first of all, we need to clarify some terms. So when we talk about CI, then this is the continuous integration. What do we do there? The developer writes code on her or his machine. After that, he or she commits the code to the source code repository. And now the code needs to be reintegrated with the rest of the code. And that's why we call this step the continuous integration, because we are reintegrating the code with the rest of the code. And this means we need to do a build for that. We need to have the code analysis. We need to have the static security analysis in there. And we need to execute the unit tests and some of the integration tests. The outcome of the continuous integration build is a deployable artifact.
Oh, that's cool. This means that we already at the build stage integrate the first security checks. That's great.
Yeah, exactly. And this is also the very important thing about the continuous integration step, because we want to have fast feedback. The developer, he or she, does not want to wait a long time to get feedback if everything is okay with the code he or she has committed to the source code repository. So we want to have feedback within minutes, not within hours or days. If you want to know more about continuous integration, then I have created these two videos which you can see up there.
Okay, Romano, I understand CI now, but why do we need CD and what is it?
Yeah, let's have a look. So just before we had a look at continuous integration, the output of continuous integration is a deployable artifact. Now, when we do continuous delivery, then we are automatically deploying this deployable artifact into a staging environment where we can test this deployable artifact or our application. And again, we want to have fast feedback back to the developer.
Okay, so now we have a running system. So we could already execute automatic penetration tests, for example, here?
Yes, of course. And this is exactly what we also should do when we are shifting left the whole security testing. So if you want to know more about continuous delivery, then I have created this video up here for you.
Oh, wait a second. It reads CD equals continuous delivery. I thought it's about continuous deployment.
Yeah, if you want to do continuous deployment, then this is a completely other thing. Let's have a look at continuous deployment. So when we look at continuous deployment, then we can clearly see that continuous deployment builds up on continuous delivery and, of course, on continuous integration. So when we look at continuous deployment, then the deployable artifact, which we have deployed onto the staging environment, is now automatically deployed into the production system.
Wait a minute. So you're saying you're deploying directly to production?
Yes, of course, because we have done the continuous integration where we have executed the unit tests, the integration tests, the static code analysis, and we have done the continuous delivery where we have deployed the deployable artifact into a staging environment. And also there we have now executed a set of automated tests in there and also some penetration tests. And because everything is green, we can now automatically deploy directly into production.
Wow. Well, can I also have an extra security gate there?
Yeah, sure. What you can introduce there is, of course, sort of a manual security gate where someone needs to trigger this deployment, which means then you are not anymore doing continuous deployment, then it's self-service deployment. So if you want to know more about continuous deployment, then I have created these two videos up here for you.
Oh, cool. Let's see whether I got that right. So we build the system on every commit, we run unit tests on every build, and we also run code analysis and my security tests on every build. In addition, we have automation of all the steps to deploy these verified changes to production if need be. And on top of all of this, we have very fast feedback so developers can act accordingly.
Yes, exactly. And this is what continuous integration and continuous deployment is all about. So when we look at CI/CD or continuous integration and continuous deployment, then such CI/CD systems are part of a continuous delivery pipeline. Here you can see an example with example tools of such a continuous delivery pipeline and how such a continuous delivery pipeline can look like and what kind of steps there can be. Of course, your continuous delivery pipeline can completely look different than this one. A continuous delivery pipeline always consists of the step continuous exploration, where you are going to get all the bright ideas and put these ideas on the backlog. You do the agile requirements engineering, and when your user story is right, then you are going into continuous integration. In the continuous integration, as we saw before, we are committing our code, and then we are going through all of these steps where we are going to verify our product with unit tests, with static code analysis, so that we create this deployable artifact. Then we are going into continuous deployment, where we are continuously deploying our changes into production. And at the end, we have the step of release on demand. And with release on demand, we are going to enable our features in production.
Excuse me? We learned we have continuous deployment, which means we release to production. And now we have here another step, release on demand. Why is that?
Yeah, when we look at continuous deployment, then one of the fundamentals of DevOps is that we separate deployment from release. And deployment is bringing the compiled code into production with the feature toggle off. And the release is enabling this feature toggle. This enables us to continuously deploy our changes into production with continuous deployment. And when the time is right and the business says, now it's the time to release this feature, then we go into release on demand, where we are going to enable the feature in production. If you want to know more about the continuous delivery pipeline, then I have created this video up there for you.
Whoa. Wow. Integrating all these tools looks like a lot of work to me.
Yeah, exactly. And this is also the difficulty. And you can see there are a lot of tools out there which you need to create such a continuous delivery pipeline. But of course, there are solutions out there. Of course, there are platforms out there which cover the whole continuous delivery pipeline. One of those platforms is GitLab, as you can see here. Of course, there is also GitHub out there, and there is Azure DevOps, and there are also other vendors out there which cover you in this continuous delivery pipeline. In this video, we will only focus on GitLab. GitLab promises you to cover the whole continuous delivery pipeline, as you can see here. That's their promise. But of course, this is not quite true. When we look at GitLab, then usually what we see is that your continuous delivery pipeline will look more like this here. So because we are focusing on security automation in this video, our continuous delivery pipeline will look like this here. So we will leave out the whole continuous exploration part, and we will also leave out the release on demand part. And instead of continuous deployment, we are only going to do continuous delivery. So our artifact will be automatically deployed into a staging environment.
Cool. Then let's build a pipeline containing, in the continuous integration part, security testing tools that do static application security testing, secret detection, software composition analysis, container scanning. And let's do, in the continuous delivery part, dynamic application security testing. Can you help me building that?
Yeah, sure. Let's have a look how we can build such a pipeline with GitLab.